Hello friends, happy Friday, welcome back to Puggsy. Having just demolished the Third World Guard, excuse me, my no damage streak continues, well no damage against bosses. I think I remember this having pretty music too. It does. Raccoon in a diving suit. Can I jump on stuff underwater? I forget if Mario rules applies here or not. In Mario, you cannot jump on enemies while underwater, but Puggsy is a cool dude, so he can. So these floating block platforms, these Minecraft grass blocks are buoyant enough that Puggsy can use it to sort of awkwardly bounce swim his way through the water. So his swimming ability is between that of Mario and Sonic. Because Mario can swim all day long. Sonic just sinks like a stone in any water environment he finds himself in. Puggsy, like, it looks a little weird, but it gets the job done. I don't think I can jump on those fish. Ah, made it. Was not sure if that would work. Alright, so we have a gun. A different looking gun. Maybe this is a gun that specifically works underwater. Yeah, it's like a harpoon gun. I think I can, like, awkwardly make my way back up there, maybe, just by moving Puggsy's arms up and down. Sort of. The gun's not as buoyant as the floating platforms were. Alright, extra life over there to the right. Harpoon. It would be cool if this was like a door somewhere that you could press up and get to a different part of the level. But it's not, it's just a background decoration. It does imply that there was like an underwater castle here at some point. Or an above water castle that was submerged by water. Well, the arrow is pointing right, and this door goes left, so this is a secret exit. Let's find out where this goes. Starfall Pool. Ah, rubber ducky. Ah, yellow submarine. There's one of these in Earthbound too. I don't know if it showed up in the randomizer. Is that a gold coin? It looks different than the other skull coins. It may be worth more points. You know, points. That very important thing that everyone's always cared about in home video games. Can I jump on the submarine underwater? Yes. Okay. Okay, I just wanted to make sure there was nothing else down there. Well, let's take this rubber ducky along just in case I need it. Because you never know. Oh, now I probably can't get up there, right? Yeah. That might be the kind of coin that you need to activate some sort of item. Or some sort of level feature. Alright, throw the ducky over there. Yeah, that's definitely a different color than the other coins. The other ones were like copper or bronze. This is gold, Jerry. Gold. Huh. Okay, so if I nudge those ducks slightly to the right, that'll activate that switch. There's another gold coin. Dang. Huh. Well, the exit is to the left. Such as it is. Like, it might not be an exit that actually leads anywhere, you know? Alright, more rubber ducks this way. Can I jump? Okay, I can jump on the fish. My instinct was not correct. Which is good. Alright, well let's Alright, nothing up there. To the left. There's an extra life down here. Oh, I probably need to activate the switch to open up the exit. Which means I need to throw that over to the right. Because I can't fit through that little gap. So I need to use these ducks. This music has a glitchy loop point too. I don't know if it's like an artifact of the emulator I'm using it. Like I don't remember if that was a thing the first time I LP'd this. I don't want to bring two gold coins back with me. Wait, the gold. I'm actually like swimming with the gold coin, even though it. Well, I got. Oh. Oh, there's a thing. I see. Oh, the exit was down here. Okay. That's still just worth 900 coins. 900 points. It's just a slightly different looking version of that item. Alright, so I can get to Badger Mill. Did this level have a, like, well, that was the normal exit for this level, right? Yeah. Yeah, because the arrow's pointing this way and then down. Okay. Well, I don't want to go to Badger Mill just yet, so let's head back to Starfall Lake and take the normal exit here. I didn't get my jumping on the thing sound effect. Yep, I can even jump on the mean looking fish. Ah! Ah, crud. Oh well. So I could. Yeah, Puggsy won't fit through this little gap. I could throw stuff at that heart and shove it until it comes out the right hand side, but not gonna worry about it. Too much effort for just a one up. Points. Oh yeah. Alright, Starfall Lake, part 2. Hey buddy. The water's down there. Nice Halloween costume, loser. Oh, that'll be fun to try to get to. And that's the direction the exit is. Alright, well let's eliminate the threats in this environment. Threats neutralized. Alright, so I guess I just need to set a rubber duck there so I have a place to stand. I don't think there's a way to get inside of that area with the fish. I think they can still hurt you through that log barrier if you're not careful. Alright. See if I can get this done with just two items. Come on, Puggsy. You can do it. That thing might be too heavy. Try it with another rubber duck. Another case where the music is really nice, but I wish... I wish the loop was longer. I mean, this is compact disc audio. Like, assuming that the data for the game takes up, you know, 2 megabytes. Well, I guess you gotta factor in the cutscenes too. But like, you can still fit, like, you know, even with the cutscenes. Well, I guess I don't know how much space they take up. But I would think you could fit more music on the disc. You wouldn't have to loop it so quickly. The hell are these scissors for? What was the point of that? Huh. Alright, I'm going to investigate. See if there's anything I can cut with these scissors. I don't think there was. I can't, like, pop the rubber ducks. Nor do I see a good reason to. Yeah, the A button doesn't do anything, so there's no, like, use effect. I do not know why it gave me these scissors. Didn't look out for the fish. Can I cut, like, the seaweed somewhere? Oh. Oh. Goodies. Okay. Huh. So what happens if I go down here? Brought that heart. What happens if I go down here is that I now have to very awkwardly try to make my way back up. I wouldn't have thought it would let me come down here. Like if that was just a place to hold those the power-ups. Like, I would have thought it would be... They would have made it too narrow for me or something, you know? Oh, this was a bad idea. Alright, come on, Puggsy. Work those arms. Feel the burn. Your whole life has prepared you for this moment. Oh, this sucks. Like, I thought there would be a secret door down there. Or a secret exit. Physics. The joy and the bane of video game players everywhere. Give Puggsy a gravity gun. My thumb's starting to hurt. Like I'm unconsciously like pushing the D-pad harder, as if that will get me out of here. All right, well, that was a nightmare. Oh, I don't think the heart is buoyant enough for me to do this. All right, Puggsy. That was some good arm moving. Well done. So I just recovered the extra life that I lost to that clam. I wish I could make the password stop popping up, since I'm not going to use it. Oh well. Splinter Town. Alright, Splinter Town. Show me what you got. Oh, this music is good too. Alright. I need a key. I need what looks like a balloon. Alright. Key and a balloon. Got it. I'm going up here because it's hard to get up here. Hey buddy. So this fox is immune to damage, apparently. So I think I need a balloon to open that trap door. Did I say fox or raccoon? It's a raccoon. I like raccoons, but there are a lot of jerk raccoons in this game. I'm remembering something about that well. Sorry, give me a second. I need to cough and take a drink. Okay, so I'm having vague memories about putting something in that well and like that little spout underneath it spitting something out. I don't remember what. It might just be a one-up. In which case, I don't know. Ah! A Kuribo shoe. I don't think it was a balloon. Because the balloon can't go, like, down into the well, right? It'll just kind of get stuck there. Right. So maybe there's something above the well. Like, it does sort of look like an arrow pointing up. Like, the top part of the well. So how's everyone doing? Okay. That was nothing. Is there anything up here? Like, if whatever the well secret is a secret level, then I would like to open it. Oh no! Invincible Raccoon is still down there. Huh. Cool glasses. It gives me a lot of balloons for some reason. I did not think that would work. And it didn't. Like, why does it give me so many balloons? I mean, I guess I can use one to investigate whatever's on top of this house, if anything. Nothing. Alright, I'm going to try to throw this seashell into the well. I'm going to fail, and then I will, I guess, complete the level. Oh my god, I was so close. Well, now I want to try again. The seashell seems to have a better arc for being thrown into the well than the apple did. Like, I don't have to jump to make it. And if I miss, it has a chance of, like, bouncing off, which is good. Ah! Except that time it just went straight down. Alright, how much time do I want to waste on this? This hunch. It's a coin. Great. Well, maybe you can throw multiple items into the well and get multiple coins and rack up a whole bunch of points. But guess what? I do not care about that. I was really hoping it would be something cooler. I mean, at least I made the basket, you know, that was pretty cool. Alright, do I have to time this, or will it just fall into the... Okay, it'll just fall and die. I'm not even gonna take that coin out of the level. Out of spite. $200 for the key. I'm fine with that. Alright, Splinter Town. This lady raccoon looks somewhat zombie-like. Maybe it's just the color of her clothing, but... Like, the red eyes... She doesn't look healthy. She looks like Zombie Nested. Those are evil clouds. I don't want to touch those. Okay, so I need to come up here with an item of some sort. Like, I knew there was a reason to come up here because I could stand on that lady's basket. Hear ye, hear ye. Puggsy is a cool guy. Look at those awesome glasses. Alright. Pay attention to the holograms. Basket? Okay. So, oh! Speed shoes. Nice. These let Puggsy run faster and jump higher. And I could have gotten one way early at the Treasure Cove if I wanted to trial and error my way through the treasure chests and figure out which one had it. So now that I know that this level contains speed shoes, I can come back for some at any time. They also provide an additional hit, just like the glasses. These things look almost like pumps, like the pump that I use to fill up the water gun that one time. But I don't think I can refill the beer mugs with them. Alright, well, now that I have speed shoes, I have a much better shot at making it up and to the right, whatever was up there. Can I jump through that? No. I don't think she actually hurts you if you touch her, but I don't want to take any chances. Secrets. I'm afraid of clouds. Alright, just that one. Secret exit. Nice. And that just loops back around to another part of Badger Mill. I will do Badger Mill in due course. Once I arrive there, in the natural sequence of events. Or when I want a diversion of some sort. With both the sunglasses and the speed shoes, there is just no limit to Pugsy's coolness. I mean, he's a fashion icon, honestly. Pyramids. Kind of weird for Splinter Town to build right next to the desert, but... Oh, I like the pyramid music. Like, it sort of has a little bit of, like, the cliche, like, ancient Egypt Arabic riff in it. But it's unique enough. So I have to use this remote control to keep an eye on this mummy, walk left and right, and guide the mummy up to the top of the pyramid. That's not the right way. So it's a little bit like that one level area in VVVVVV. When you have to... I don't remember which character's name corresponds to which part, but when Viridian has to guide one of their crewmates and they just they mirror your actions. It's like that. So I think I can just... Yeah, it won't walk off the edge. So I can sort of line it up like that. Okay. Oh, it will jump off the edge though. Alright, Mummy. You're doing good. I'm proud of you, Mummy. Oh, which one of these do I want to fall down? I don't want to fall down it. Well, that one just drops a coin. Oh, I don't remember. Like, there's two switches down there. I guess that was the right one. I'll take it. Alright, beach ball party in the pyramid. Okay, so when I throw the beach balls into this device, it'll teleport into one of those chambers, and it will keep the momentum. So if I, like, throw it from this side... Okay. So it's like, it's like an early version of Portal, where you're using portals to guide items, and like they keep their momentum, and that's part of the puzzle. Like this game, it has a lot of clever ideas that showed up in later games, of course, probably not directly inspired by Puggsy, but still, like, it did a lot of stuff. Oh no! I've lost one. Well, it gives me four. Ah. Man, it's weird to think that when I LP'd this game the first time, that was 2007. I know VVVVVV wasn't out. I think Portal might have come out in 2007. I don't remember if this was the first time I LP'd this was before or after Portal. It was definitely before I played Portal, so I wouldn't have even been able to make these references the first time. Like, that's how long ago it was. That is wild to think about. Ah, made it. Alright. But there's more to this level. Alright, there's a mummy door and an exit door. Ah. Gotta bring a beach ball. Always bring a beach ball, Puggsy. What were you thinking? Rule number one for pyramid exploration. Always bring a beach ball. So I unleashed the mummies. Oh, does that just open? Oh, I see. Okay. So they're going to use the items that they're carrying. And I just got to run. Excellent. 100 point beach ball. Well, that will do it for this episode. I'm going to leave you on a cliffhanger because we have the boss of the pyramids coming up next. So thank you all for watching. I'm having a real good time going through this game again. I hope you're having a good time watching me. Thank you, and I will talk to you soon. Have a good weekend. Goodbye.